We have uncovered wonders undreamt by our ancestors who first speculated on the nature.
As we embark on a groundbreaking epoch in the chronicles of astronomy, the world bears witness to the unparalleled prowess of NASA's James Webb Space Telescope. Unveiling cosmic enigmas, the JWST found six colossal galaxies, the likes of which some expert once deemed inconceivable. With its extraordinary capabilities, the telescope stands poised to revolutionize our comprehension of the cosmos, challenging the very foundation of our scientific knowledge. But do these astonishing discoveries truly shatter our understanding of the universe?
Our best understanding of the beginning moments of the universe, you have this sort of cauldron of matter and energy that isn't quite in a situation yet to form stars or galaxies or any sort of tangible objects we know and love later. And so there's this period of time we identify as the Dark Ages, where, yeah, there was matter and energy, but nothing shining yet. And the matter still had to coalesce and organize into these cities we call galaxies, cities of stars. So here you have this gap. And now the James Webb Space Telescope is identifying objects in the Dark Ages that, by best measurements we have, are large, fully developed galaxies. So we're justifiably befuddled by it, but there's still other data that can still come in from these galaxies that will derive from their spectra. And when you get a spectrum of a galaxy, it's like the fingerprint of all the chemistry that's going on in there, as well as where we would put it in the expansion model of the universe. Because maybe they're just a weird other kind of object and not the kind of object we think it should be. Because if it's a new kind of object, that's also a discovery. And by the way, the James Webb Space Telescope was conceived and designed to help us understand the origin of galaxies. So we shouldn't be surprised that it's forcing us to scratch our head.
Well, that's the problem. The James Webb Space Telescope is upsetting the apple cart. All of a sudden, we realize that we may have to rewrite all the textbooks about the beginning of the universe. Now, it takes many billions of years to create a galaxy like the Milky Way galaxy with 100 billion stars, many billions of years old. But the James Webb Telescope has identified six galaxies that exist half a billion years after the Big Bang, that are up to 10 times bigger than the Milky Way galaxy. That shouldn't happen. There should not be primordial galaxies that are bigger than the Milky Way galaxy that are only half a billion years old. Something is wrong. We may have to revise our theory of the creation of the universe.
Yes, we expect James Webb to make great discoveries. We expect that. But the first order of business is hardly ever, let's discover something new today. It's, here's something that we have limited understanding of, let's improve on that. And in so doing, we deepen our understanding of how things work in the universe. That doesn't always involve overturning a previous idea or discovering something that nobody ordered, all right? That will happen, we fully expect that to happen, but we targeted parts of the sky initially, because we know other telescopes have gone there before. And we're going to say, how can we further advance and deepen our understanding?
Before we answer whether the James Webb Space Telescope is shattering our understanding of the cosmos, let us take a moment to appreciate its remarkable achievements. The James Webb Space Telescope has captured a breathtaking, high-resolution portrayal of the legendary Pillars of Creation, the very birthplace of the stars, first immortalized by NASA's Hubble telescope in 1995. Nestled within dense clouds of gas and dust, new stars are birthed in these remarkable structures. Though these three-dimensional pillars may resemble unearthly rock formations, they are far more permeable. Composed of cool interstellar gas and dust, these celestial columns can appear semi-transparent when illuminated by near-infrared light. Building upon the seminal images captured in 1995, Webb's fresh perspective on the Pillars of Creation provides researchers the tools necessary to refine their models of star formation. With more accurate counts of nascent stars, as well as the quantities of gas and dust in the region, scientists are poised to gain a deeper understanding of these enigmatic processes. As we unravel the intricacies of stellar formation, we will begin to discern how stars emerge from these cosmic clouds, a process spanning millions of years.
Is it the remnants of a star that has died? The sun will have a fate such as this, where at the end its outer layers of gas will escape into space and slowly drift away. It makes for spectacular, beautiful imagery. We are seeing things better in more detail than ever before, not only nearby, but far away. And it's a star that has released this gas, and it's called a planetary nebula. It has nothing to do with the planet, but these objects are all over the galaxy, and this is an example of what the telescope can do. We are looking past several stars sitting on our nose in our own Milky Way galaxy. These are the spiked objects that are here. Ignore them. They're just in the way. What we're actually looking towards is a galaxy cluster halfway to the edge of the universe, and has a very strong gravitational field surrounding it. Meanwhile, galaxies behind it, these that are curved into arc shapes, they're like passing through the universe, minding its own business. It sees this distortion in the fabric of space and time, and it curves. These are entire galaxies of commensurate rank and privilege. If you take a grain of sand and hold it at arm's length, the patch of sky covered by the grain of sand is what you see here. By the way, these spikes occur because of light as it passes through the spider mounting of the secondary mirror diffracts around it. So there's nothing cosmic about that. It's a hardware artifact within the telescope. Because the telescope is tuned for infrared, infrared has good penetration depth into gas clouds. By the way, it's the same reason why your fog lights on your car are more red and amber than blue. The more red you are into the spectrum, the deeper into clouds you can penetrate. And when you do that, you have access to places where stars are being born, as well as planetary systems around them. In your eye, you have red, green, and blue RGB sensors in your retina. And what happens is, what we define as visible light is the light that comes through and is detected by these three. Those get combined into a single color image of what you see in your brain. Now, think about that. This entire telescope is tuned for the infrared. What the telescope does is it can take images in three different bands, separate bands of the infrared. Then you hand it an RGB and create a color picture. We are seeing things better in more detail than ever before.
Beyond the reach of the naked eye lies a realm of celestial wonders that the James Webb Space Telescope unveils, transporting us through light and space to the very origins of the universe, a concept that challenges the limits of human comprehension. Functioning as a cosmic time machine, the pioneering images divulged by this extraordinary telescope reveal distant galaxies, the birth and demise of stars, and the mysteries of the cosmos. Now, over a year since its triumphant launch, James Webb has bestowed upon scientists and humankind alike awe-inspiring images from the depths of space. These visuals shed light on the atmospheres of planets both within and beyond our solar system. For instance, NASA has unveiled stunning shots of Jupiter, the solar system's largest planet, with results described as nothing short of incredible. Capturing unparalleled views of Jupiter's northern and southern auroras, as well as its swirling polar haze, the James Webb Telescope explores the majesty of the gas giant. The Great Red Spot, a tempest vast enough to engulf Earth, shines brilliantly among a myriad of smaller storms. As we journey further into the cosmos, the James Webb Space Telescope may also hold the key to unravel enigmas of distant alien worlds.
Many people don't realize this telescope is way bigger than the fairing that launched it on the rocket. And so the engineers said, let's figure out how to fold the telescope, stick it in the fairing, and then unfold it a million miles out where it's parked. We were shocked for it having met the specs, because there were so many ways that could have failed, that when it met what it was designed to do, we were shocked. So it looked at to the edge of the universe, finding galaxies being born, and because it's infrared, it peers through nearby gas clouds. Stars are made of gas. They're made from gas clouds. So when you peer in, you see the stellar nursery that lurks within. So this is a gas cloud. Deep within is forming brand new stars. It's a stellar nursery. And it's forming not only stars, but planets in orbit around them. And so we now have more than 5,000 exoplanets in the catalog. And this telescope is going to be among its many abilities, it'll be able to measure the chemistry of the atmosphere of exoplanets that pass in front of their host star.
As we ponder whether the James Webb Space Telescope truly shatters our understanding of the universe, one thing is clear. JWST is undeniably enriching our cosmic knowledge. By unveiling the mysteries of celestial phenomena, this exceptional observatory is expanding our comprehension of the cosmos and redefining the boundaries of human discovery.
Here's the way to think about it. If you came up to a house and had a lawn, and your vision was not all that good, you say, oh, there's a green carpet, all right, surrounding it. And that's accurate. But if you have better vision, more resolution, you say, wait a minute, there are blades of grass there. So this is an extra detail, deeper than what you had first thought. It doesn't change your view, it adds to it. Not every scientific discovery changes what we thought before. Now, here's a problem. As the area of our knowledge grows, so too does the perimeter of our ignorance.